So this is Manoj right here, and I'm going to take you guys through how to hinge by coaching him. Okay, so first of all, you guys need to understand what a hinge is. So hinge is basically you pushing your butt back, okay? So this is essentially the function of your glutes, right? You push your hips back. So that is the function of the glutes. So when you do this, not only your glutes work, but also your hamstrings work. So I'm going to show, Manoj is going to show you guys how to do it. So let's say he's right here. So let's say you have a bar here, okay? Okay. So he's going to do a dumbbell deadlift. So that's what translates into a hinge essentially, okay? So core tight, brace, push your hips back. Okay, now hold. So you see this? Head, upper back and his glutes all in a straight line. So a lot of people, what they do is show them how not to do hinge. People arch their back too much, right? So look at this. This is not what we want. Okay, this will get you like really bad. Or they arch too much. Again. People think it goes around like this. So you need to have like a neutral spine. So that's what creates a good hinge, and you should not feel anything on your lower back. Again, do them a proper hinge. Deep breath, core tight. Shoulders tucked in, stop. You don't need to go all the way down. You only go as long as it is comfortable for you, okay? So you don't have to go touch the floor and come back up. So you stop right here. This, this, and this, always along the movement, remains in a straight line. Start one more time. Put your shoulder back, squeeze your mid back, keep your core tight, nice and tight, so load doesn't go to your lower back. See this? The straight line is always maintained, and that is how you do a hinge, and that is how you do a deadlift, that is how you do a dumbbell deadlift, whatever deadlift you want, this is how you do it. I'm going to show you guys one more drill on how to actually get the hinge right, and if you are someone struggling to get the hinge right, this particular drill will help you to figure it out, okay? And even if you're a coach, you guys can follow it on your clients, and that will get them good results on how to hinge. So this is how you actually start practicing a hinge, okay? So this is called as a wall tap. All you have to do is place yourself with your butt facing the wall, take a small step forward. So again, make sure you guys always take a really good deep breath and hold your core really tight, and then slowly start pushing only your butt back until you tap the wall. So you tap it, and then you come back up. That's it. So when you do this, make sure your knees are not tight. You don't have to lock your knees, leave them really loose. All you're trying to move is only your hips. One more time. Tap your butt to the wall, come back up. So once you know that this step is okay, take a small step forward, and what this will do is increase your hinge. So you can again practice it one more time. Tap, come back up. So slowly as you move further and further, your hinge is getting better and better. And finally, when you guys are ready to hinge without the wall, that is when you can slowly start moving on to exercises like your dumbbell deadlift or your barbell deadlift or anything, okay? So I would always suggest to start with something like a dumbbell deadlift and then slowly graduate to a barbell. So once you're ready, step completely forward, and then you can start hinging without the wall on your back. So again, take a deep breath. You should not feel your lower back at all, and push your hips back. Go back only as long as you're comfortable, and then come back up. All of us have different heights, so you don't have to push all the way back and struggle with it, okay? So this is how you start doing a hinge. So thank you so much for watching this video, and hope you guys got something out of it. Make sure you guys go and implement this, okay? Don't just learn it and not use it. So we will also be coming out with more videos like this on the foundation series. Next video will probably be on how to do a proper bench press. Okay, so thank you so much for watching, guys. If you guys enjoyed this, make sure you guys like the video and subscribe to this channel, and also press the bell button nearby so that you get a notification whenever I upload a video. Also follow me on Instagram at gymandsuperfit, and follow the gym at OneSS. All links are down in the description box. Also follow Manoj. I'll put all of the links down here. And I'll see you guys on next video. Peace out.